Oil prices rising today as war breaks out between Israel and Hamas, the attack stretching into their third day. Crude and Brent both up over 4%. And joining us now is Pavel Molchanov, energy and clean tech analyst at Raymond James. Pavel, let me start there. I'm looking at Brent. It's over 4% to 88. How do you think this new war between Israel and Hamas could affect the price of oil going forward? I realize, Pavel, you know, listen, it's a fluid, dynamic situation, a lot of moving parts, but how are you thinking about it?
Israel and all of its immediate neighbors, the Gaza Strip, West Bank, Jordan, Lebanon, and Syria, none of these countries or territories produce oil in significant quantities. Let's just put that on the table. The only way in which this war could physically disrupt oil supply is if Iran makes a decision to openly enter the war on the side of Hamas. Now, Iran has had more than four decades since the Islamic Revolution of hostility to Israel, but not once during that time has Iran openly, you know, engaged in a military confrontation with Israel. Why? Because the Iranians know that they would lose. Israel is a nuclear-armed country and has the largest air force in the region. If Iran does this, it would be their biggest mistake in four decades, and I do not think the Iranian regime is suicidal. So the odds that this war will have a physical effect on oil supply from the Middle East is very low.
Pavel, it's Julie here. It's great to see you. Josh and I really enjoyed your note that you wrote with your colleagues, looking at the history of conflict in that region, now 50 years since the Yom Kippur War. You just talked to us about some of that, putting that what's happened in context. But as you also point out in that note, a lot of other things have changed between then and now in terms of the dynamics of the oil market. So what do people need to keep in mind, sort of thing one, as they watch what's happening on the ground there and as they watch oil prices go up?
Well, so here's the good news. Even in the worst case scenario of Iran getting into this war explicitly on the side of Hamas, again, I don't believe this will happen, but even in that scenario, the world has enough strategic oil reserves to provide more than enough cushion for such an eventuality. So in the United States, there is the Strategic Petroleum Reserve, SPR. All of the other members of the International Energy Agency, so all of the European countries, Japan, Korea, Australia, they all have their own emergency reserves. And that is something that did not exist in 1973 during the Arab oil embargo. So compared to 50 years ago, when, you know, some of our listeners will remember there were gasoline lines, there was a three-day work week in the UK because of fuel shortages, none of that would happen, even if Iran, you know, gets into this war. The world is prepared. And indeed, we saw this during the immediate aftermath of Russia's invasion of Ukraine in February of last year, when prices spiked on fears that what if the Kremlin decides to cut off its oil exports, but then the emergency stockpiles were gradually drawn down, and guess what? Prices dropped by, at one point, by 50%.